In this video, learn how to make an object move around from path to path in one simple node only, and how to make player be able to walk on this moving block. Understand how weight of object will affect it, and understand stuck issue or pushback issue when player on moving object. You can download the whole project free with link under video. It just take a few seconds to load it. Open it with Unity version 2021, 2022, or any newer versions. Last video, we learned how to move an enemy or an object in visual scripting. You can watch again with link under video. I created a 3D cube with name moving block. It cannot move now. Remember, add a box collider for player can walk on it. Our player can stand and walk on this 3D cube. Next, let's make this object moving. Open this folder, sample visual scripting plus. It is free with link under video. In this video, let's use this to move object. I use this to move most of my character, enemy or objects. Simply just copy and paste, that's it. Today, we will use event move to paths. This one requires add script macro character to moving object and component rigid body to move that object. Step 1, add script macro character to moving object. And component rigid body to move object. Let's turn off gravity, we don't need it for this moving object. And freeze all rotation to stop it spinning. Step 2, open use character, copy event to use. If you have visual scripting plus, macro character is here. Let's copy event move to paths. Create a new visual scripting script on this moving block. Name it moving obstacle or any names you like. Let's move this object at start of the game. Paste the copied event here. Input object is object calling this event, this current moving block. Input path list. Input path list is a list of game objects that moving block will move to. Let's create some path objects to move our object around them. Make this cube size smaller. And move it to a position that you want this moving block will move to. Remove it from moving block. Rename it to path 1. Duplicate it to create object path 2. Move object path 2 to another position. Moving block will move around this path 1 and path 2. Let's add all objects path 1 and path 2 into a list variable. Name it path list or any names you like. With type of list, add object path 1 into. And object path 2. You can add many path objects as you want to this list. Now put the path list to our moving event. Input speed is the speed of movement. Let's create a variable name speed to control this value. Waiting time is the break time. After moving block arrive to a path object, set it 0 if you want to keep moving without break time. Remember to remove collider from path objects, or it will block other moving objects. Now press play to see how it works. With one simple node event, moving block can move around as expected. Let's try to jump on this moving block. If a heavy thing stands on, it will drop down like this. I will freeze its Y value. If something hit a moving object, it will apply a force to push this object away. So how to fix the weight and this force issue? Mass is like the weight of object. Change mass value of moving object 200. And current player's mass value is 1. Player's mass value is much smaller than moving block now. Player will not affect the movement of our block anymore. The issue was fixed. When player stands on moving block and walk on it, it seems player is standing at the same place or stuck. But if player runs, he can get rid out of it, so why? First, let's watch on speed of moving block. It has value as 2. And player walk speed has value as 2 as well. But run speed is 4, bigger than moving block speed. So, if player's speed slower than moving block, player will walk at place or push backward. And if player's speed faster than moving block, he can move on this block with no problems. To resolve it, I will make player's speed always bigger than moving object. First, make sure you added tag player to your main player. And it has variable walk speed and run speed. We will change these speed always bigger than moving block speed. When the game starts, let's get speed of player from this moving block. We will store player speed to some graph variables. Player origin walk speed. Player origin run speed. New walk speed. And new run speed. Now let's get variable walk speed from object player. We will store it into player origin walk speed. To get player object, use find game object with tag. To get variable inside an object, use get object variable. Let's get current player walk speed. Find game object with tag. We'll return this object with tag player. And on this object, we have variable walk speed and run speed. Do the same to get value of player run speed. Now let's fix the speed of player when he is standing on this moving block. To make sure all speed of player bigger than speed of moving block, we will add speed of moving block to speed of player. Player new walk speed will be old walk speed plus moving block speed. Do the same for new run speed of player. Now we already have new speed of player when he stands on moving block. In last videos, we used player feet box cast to detect any objects that player is standing on. And this collider has option, is trigger is true. Now let's open script of moving block. On trigger enter, to detect any collider touch this block. Current script is inside moving block, input this, is moving block collider. If moving block collider touches any other collider, this event will trigger. Compare the name of collider, to see if it touching player feet box cast. If this is true, it means player is standing on moving block. If player standing on moving block, change his walk speed to new walk speed. We already have value of player new walk speed since game is started. And we apply player new run speed too. Copy all these events. Replace it with on trigger exit. Whenever moving block, do not touch player object anymore. Let's reset player walk speed to his original walk speed. We do reset run speed as well. All done, press play to see our final result. Let's watch player walk speed and run speed value. When player is on ground, walk speed has value is 2 only, but player standing on moving block, walk speed has value is 4. Bigger than speed of moving block, so player can walk on this block easily. Player walk speed is reset after he left the moving block. This method will work on any 2D or 3D games. You can download this script with link under video. Thank you for watching. See you in next video.